Hello my dear students, in this video we are going to study one of the lab programs, that is write a program to create a class with the data members A, B, C and member functions to input data, compute the discriminant based on the following conditions and print the roots. If discriminant is equal to 0, print the roots that are equal. If discriminant is greater than 0, print the real roots. If the discriminant is less than 0, print the roots are imaginary. As you can see here, I have written the multi-line comment, write a program to create a class with data members A, B, C and member functions to input data, compute the discriminant based on the following conditions and print the roots. If discriminant is equal to 0, print the roots that are equal. If the discriminant is greater than 0, print the real roots. If the discriminant is less than 0, print that the roots are imaginary. Here you can see I have already written the preprocessor directives, that is header files, hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h and hash include math.h. Math.h is used to use one particular inbuilt function sqrt. While writing the program, we are going to see that one later on. So let us continue with class definition. So here we will write the name of the class as squared, then here we will declare all the data members with the floating type of data. Here I'll write A, B and C, then x1 as first root, x2 as second root of the equation, then we are going to use imaginary part, then we'll write real part, then discriminant, put semicolon, then we will write public member access specifiers. Public is a keyword and here we will write void get data, then we'll use cout statement to enter the values of A, B and C. Enter the values of A, B and C, put semicolon, then cin, accept the value of A, accept the value of B and accept the value of C, and then we'll calculate discriminant. So here discriminant is nothing but it's a formula, that is B square minus 4AC. Here we can write B into B is B square minus 4 into A into C. Now curly closing brace. Next we will define one more function member, that is void put data, and here curly open brace, and then we are going to check the conditions. So here we'll check the condition with the discriminant. If discriminant is greater than 0, then we have to print the roots or calculate the roots as x1 is equal to minus b plus sqrt. So sqrt is the function which is present inside the math.h. So that's the reason we have included hash include math.h header file in this particular program. Now here we can see that minus b plus sqrt, and here inside the round braces we will write discriminant whole divided by 2a. Then we will go for calculating the second root. So that is x2 is equal to minus b. Next here we will write minus instead of plus, because x1 receives plus value and x2 receives the negative value. So sqrt, and inside the round brace again we will write discriminant whole divided by 2 into a. Next, we need to display the values stored in these two roots. So here we will write roots are real and different. Cout. Here I'm going to display the values stored in x1 by writing x1 and then x2. In a double quotation mark, you can write x2, then print the value stored in x2. Now curly closing brace. Next, we are going to check condition else if, and here we are going to see if the discriminant is equal to 0. Here double equal to, it is one of the relational operators which is used to compare the value with the discriminant. Here we'll write x1 is equal to minus b whole divided by 2a, that is 2 into a. Here if the discriminant is 0, then so minus b whole divided by 2a is left out. So here we will print the result as the roots are real and equal. Then we want to display the value stored in the roots. So there are two roots present in each quadratic equation. Here x1 is equal to x2 because roots are real and equal. So that's the reason I'm going to write here x1 is equal to x2 is equal to. So that is the value stored in x1. Now curly closing brace. Next else part. What is going to happen if the discriminant is less than 0? Then we'll display the result as the roots are imaginary. So here we'll write real part is equal to minus b whole divided by 2 into a, put semicolon, then we'll write imaginary part is equal to square root of minus discriminant whole divided by 2 into a. Then we need to display the result. Here roots are imaginary, backward slash n, then we will write cout. Here we'll print real part plus imaginary part . So in double quotation mark we'll write I, that represent imaginary part, then we'll use end L, put semicolon. Next we'll write cout. Real part in a double quotation mark. One is positive real imaginary number and one more is negative imaginary number. So that's the reason you can see here one is plus and one more is negative. Now we'll write imaginary part of negative imaginary number, imaginary part, and then we'll write I and put semicolon and curly closing brace for else part and one more curly closing brace for if condition and one more curly closing brace for end of class definition, put semicolon, then we will write void main, and here we are going to create the object of this class. So name of the class is called as quad and Q is the object. So with the help of this object, we'll be able to call the member functions. So that is Q dot get data, put semicolon, then Q dot, we'll write put data and put semicolon, next get ch and curly closing brace. So alt F9 to check the errors, you can see get data, so it is giving error. So it is get data, make changes, then success, there is no error. Next control F9 to run the program. Now you can see it is asking you to enter the values of A, B and C. So let us enter 1, 2 and 3. You can see that roots are imaginary and it is displaying the values. Next, one more time we are going to run the program. Next it is asking enter the values of A, B, C. Now I am going to enter the values such as 1, 5 and 6. Now you can see roots are real and different. So here x1 is equal to minus 2 and x2 is equal to minus 3. Next, one more time I am going to execute this program to enter different values to check all the three conditions. Now you can see enter the values of A, B and C. Now we are going to enter the values such as 1, then 4 and 4. Now you can see the roots are real and equal. Here x1 is equal to, x2 is equal to minus 2. So all the three conditions are satisfied. That's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this video. We will see you in the next video.